All right, guys, so this is pretty much where we're at. Next step, I think we'll go with just the German field grey, again from Vallejo. And we'll just start doing some light coats over the top of this and sort of around the straps and everything and try and get something that starts looking a little bit like a painted figure for a beginner. Some easy steps. As you can see, my wet palette's still there. This is probably about, I don't know now, it's been sitting here now for about, whoops, bit of water got in there, for about 8 hours. And we'll start with the next part, which is, again, give your green a bit of a good shake up. It's always good to leave a bit of space on your wet palette between the colours, so that gives you a bit of a chance to do a bit of mixing later on. I actually don't mind getting a bit of, maybe not that much, a bit of extra water in my palette, because I can always then just bring it over here, little drips and drabs, if I want to make this a little bit thinner, which is probably what we'll do when we start off. We'll just grab a bit of this water and we'll slap it over here. And this is what I like about this this sort of technique, guys, or I don't know if you call it a technique, just the way I do it is that it's very easy if you make a mistake, especially when you're paint is very thin. As you can see, it's even sort of curling up on the palette here, but you can just go on very lightly and then you can just choose later to go on thicker. So you can see, even if, as I'm covering this, I can sort of bring the paint around a little bit, and if it's too thick, because it's thin paint, I can just sort of bring it around and move it to a different area. So I'll just slap this on. And I've watched a lot of painting videos in my time, and I've done a bit of painting. I wouldn't say I'm a professional painter, but you know, I'm an okay painter. I've won a couple of medals at shows and stuff like that. But what I'd say about this technique is that it's very forgiving. So if you can see this now, and hopefully it'll show up, I mean, even though I've painted over the top of this, you can still see the outlining underneath. And seriously, the thinner you do it, you obviously don't want it too thin like water, so it'll run down the whole leg and disappear down to the bottom of your base. So, but the beauty of doing this is that you can do a thin coat and then you can let that dry. And then if you want to do another coat, and you don't have to do it all over the figure, you can pick certain areas, like maybe some of the creases that you are too dark and you want to bring it back again, you can just let this dry and you can go over it with another coat. And you don't even really need to let it dry. You can still go over and do it again. Probably for beginning, it might be easier if you just let a little coat dry and then you can have a bit of a look of it, go away for a while, have a bit of a break. And then you can come back and decide if you want to add an extra layer. And that's the beauty of when you're doing it thin. The also beauty of it doing it thin is that you're a lot less likely to get those sort of terrible brush strokes in your paintwork. Now, as you can see, if that's drying, you can sort of see how some of the creases will show up a little bit more than others. The other thing is you just need to be careful if it's too runny, too much water in it, that it might pool in the creases or the ditches. So you just need to be a little bit careful of that. But as you can see, straight up, you know, compared to, and I don't mean to be rude, some beginners out there maybe using Tamiya paints and that, I mean, this literally takes seconds and it actually comes out as a reasonably decent result. And this is out without using like Tamiya colours, any washes, any other sort of, you know, pigments or anything like that. Just the primer and two paints, and you can pretty much decide as you're going along now. If you think, oh, this knee area here, this kneecap, you want that to be a bit more faded, a bit lighter, You can do that, and then you can also start just moving the green around a little bit, like we did with the black, and start deciding where you want your sort of a bit more green. So rather than just the creases in black, you can start sort of darkening the green up a little bit to make some area. And this is before we put any highlights in. In one way, sometimes even the grey coming through the primer still acts as a bit of a highlight in certain areas. But hopefully you'll get the gist of that. And, you know, again, you just keep going around the top. Obviously, now that we've done the black around the pouches and all the German grey, I think, around the pouches and the straps, you don't really want to go over those again in green. So the best you can, just try and avoid those places. But the beauty of this is, there's when you're starting, guys, there's no right or wrong. You know, Bob Ross, lovely Bob Ross. You know, they're just happy little accidents. And the beauty of this sort of wet palette is, if you make a mistake, no biggie. I mean, and that's what I like about, if you're just starting out having minimal colours, maybe three colours, because you know if you make a mistake, you know, oh, I'll just go back to the green and I'll pick that colour up, or I'll go back to the black or German grey and pick that colour up. So there's no trying to mix colours to get that sort of colour that you want back that you can't remember what you mixed. So very simple. And I think I would have much preferred if I started with a wet palette those, you know, 20 years ago or something, or 30 years ago maybe, when I started painting. I would have preferred if I just started with a wet palette. I think I would have been miles ahead with my painting. But as you can see, guys, nothing much really here in the way of secrets. It's not hard to do. It's just outline, just block out your little creases around your detailing with your black, and then slowly go in with your field grey. The nice thing about outlining with the black first, it just gives you a little bit more of a feeling of your work area and where you need to go with the green. And you can sort of, if it's light enough, even though you're going over the black with the green, you can still see the black or the German grey through there. So hopefully you can pretty much see what I'm doing here. Again, because I don't do ads on my channels, guys, I can only run a 15-minute video because they won't let me do any longer than that unless I put ads on my channel, which I don't really want to do at the moment. Well, I haven't done it for the last, I don't know, 8 or 9 years. So it does annoy me because I also can't pick my own, you know, the picture on the front of your video. I can't pick that either unless I actually do ads. So for that reason, I might end up putting ads on my channel just so I can actually pick my, I can't think of the word, you know, your I can't remember what it is. Because sometimes your picture on the front of your video when you're searching YouTube, and it is a bit annoying because sometimes I may actually pick something and, or YouTube picks three pictures that I have to pick from, and sometimes it might just have my thumb in the way or something else if I'm doing a review or something. So it's kind of pretty frustrating in a way. So I've done 8 or 9 years without ads, so hopefully I can be forgiven for putting ads on my channel when that happens. And again, if it gets too, if you go over this like I've just done there, and you think, oh, that's too thick in green, and your black's not showing through your shadows, just go grab a little bit of water on your brush, and you can just come back, and you can just brush that off. And again, even if you see here it's starting to pool a bit, you can just, oh, here's my hand here, you can just suck that water off the brush, or off the figure, sorry, and you can regain those low lights back again. Simple as that. And all I can say is, this is it's easy to do, guys. It's not rocket science when you're doing it this way, and it's very forgiving. Anyway, guys, because of my 15-minute limit, I'm gonna leave that with you, and we'll come back when this is done. So here we are, guys, and I'm pretty much just at the end of doing this feel grey part. And as you can see, as I've shown before, the dark creases, you can just go over those just gently once it dries a little bit with a little bit more, and you can just cover the dark creases up again, all the German grey, until you're happy with that sort of colour sort of blending in and looking a little bit more like the shadow that you want it to be. So for two colours, this is great with the Tamiya primer, because it really does let you give that sort of faded look if you want, and you can decide that by just how much you want to thin the paint out. Or as you can see, it's a little bit grayer here, the primer, but you can just go over it again with the green diluted, and you can just decide. Yeah, this is before we do any real highlights or anything, and you can just decide how much of that grey primer you want to let through and how much you don't. So the next step we'll probably move on to is we might just add a little bit of this. Well, you can do white, whatever. This is just the colour I picked out, guys. And this is the Ivory by Vallejo. And we'll probably just add that to probably the field grey a little bit. And we'll just do some little highlights and stuff like that. So we'll do that in our next video.